Selena's singing career began when she was in elementary school. She was 8 years old when she sang a duet with her dad, Abraham Quintanilla.
For eternity, eternity.
Daughter's always attached to daddy. You know, and then also, you know, in Selena, I saw a lot of me when I was young.
Quintanilla was a member of a group called Los Ninos. They played doo-wop music some 30 years ago, and Selena took a liking to the sound. Tejano music pioneer Johnny Herrera was one of the first to recognize Selena's talent and recorded it on cassette.
I told her father, listen, this kid has it. She doesn't go out of tune. She belts the song out. And sure enough, she made it big.
Eventually, Selena's father recruited his two other children to form a new family band that kept the old name Los Ninos. Suzette played drums and Abby was on guitar. By the time Selena was 11, she and Los Ninos had become regular performers on the KIII TV Spanish variety show Domingo.
Corazoncito, corazoncito, que no te vuelvas a enamorar. Corazoncito, corazoncito, que no te vuelvan a lastimar. Te enamoraste de mil amores y te ha dejado puros dolores.
By the time Selena was 16, she was dancing more freely and letting her personality surface.
Para subir al cielo se necesita una escalera grande, otra chiquito, allá arriba, iré, yo no soy marinero, soy capitán. Bamba, una vez que te dije que eras bonita, se te puso la cara coloradita. Allá arriba, iré, yo no soy marinero, por ti seré. Pero los chinos le dan saborcito, pero bonito. Allá arriba, iré, yo no soy marinero, soy capitán. Bamba, bamba.
Am I bothering you?
We'll be right back.
She attended public school right here in her neighborhood, but dropped out to pursue her singing career. Eventually, Selena did get a GED and became an advocate for staying in school and off drugs.
Just 4 months before her death, Selena was at Cunningham Middle School in Corpus Christi, promoting a new video that traces the history of Mexican-American music. By then, she had already been recognized numerous years as a Tejano superstar. Model for young Hispanics who could identify with her. She came from a humble background, worked hard, and was realizing her dreams.
I feel that education is very important nowadays, and I feel that I'm in the perfect position to be helping out other children, since a lot of families and children, parents encourage the children to use me as a role model. And I feel that that's an honor. So I feel that I should be, that I'm, since I'm in a position, I should set the example.
Her former teachers all described her as a brilliant student who could have easily become an honor graduate.
Because she loved to sew, and she had already decided that she was going to be a designer and have her own boutique along with her music. So my class fit into her plans.
After so many years of teaching, I had a little girl that idolized her, and I always told her how I had taught Selena, and that one of these days she'd get to meet her.
She was very loving, and she was one of those students that came in and gave you a hug, just spontaneously.
Selena missed a lot of school. Usually she was absent on Fridays and Mondays because the family traveled weekends across the state to perform quinceañeras and weddings. Could her love for school have been the reason she performed a Spanish rendition of the 1960 song, To Sir With Love? Fine blend of music and personality began catching the eyes of music executives. Eventually, she landed a six-figure contract with EMI Latin Records. Selena was on her way to becoming Tejano Music's first female star. It was her music, hip dance moves, and sexy costumes that attracted fans to Selena. It was this performance at the Tejano Music Awards in San Antonio in 1989 that caught the attention of Jose Bejar, president of EMI Latin Records.
One of the primary goals that I had was to find the next Gloria Estefan. You know, an artist that would be not only bilingual, but bicultural. Gloria had opened the door, and the door was ajar, but I think Selena blew it wide open. She was just hip, she was cool, she was genuinely Hispanic, you know, Mexican roots at heart.
Soon, she signed a record contract with EMI Latin and went on to win eight consecutive Tejano Entertainer of the Year awards. But her biggest honor came last year when she won a Grammy for the album Selena Live. Her music not only inspired Selena wannabes, but other Tejano artists as well.
She was probably the top Tejano act right now, selling, besides the states, here, selling in other countries. And she really opened a lot of doors. Of course, her music will always live. However, she will not be with us, and that's the tough part. I guess we miss her personality.
A lot of people that knew her off the stage, you know, they thought, oh yeah, she's a great person. She is. But there was a lot more to Selena that a lot of people didn't know. She's one of a kind, unique person. And her music, I feel her now through my music.
We have to give thanks for the time we did have her, and be proud that we were the same blood and the same race, and so much that we were able to share, and so much that the world knows now of us.